fix this. Why does it look like shit? I always have this problem with this fucking game. It looks weird. Ugh, God. What up, Quan? What up, boyos? I don't know, I just got home and I turned my stream on. Star Carrier billboard. Where's the Star Carrier billboard? I guess it's not over here. What up, Tails? So how was it? It was a movie. Like from a movie standpoint, which is not what I watched it for. Oh, they're not? But yeah, I'm gonna talk about the movie, and Soul City wanted to see it, so I'm not gonna go in there and start talking about it. Like, it's your generic old movie with Power Ranger themes. It's not a Power Rangers movie by any means. Other than, the name is there. What did I do? Oh, I fucked the lance up. Okay. What up, Tux? I dislike a lot about this movie. Like, holy shit. Wow. They did a lot of taboo things that I dislike at all. Like, they labeled it completely wrong. It's not a Power Rangers movie at all. Like, I get what they were trying to do. They were trying to develop the characters. But nobody cares about that. We know the fucking story. I know you're trying to baby step new fans in. But they get the gist. They don't need to be, you know... They don't need to be baby like this. Also, the characters were just not likable. Like, I just didn't care. Obviously, you know, I'm old man. Like, I'm gonna go fucking heavily into the story. Like, I'm gonna break this shit down, you know. Not frame by frame, but pretty much scene by scene. So the movie opens up, you know, war-torn fucking... Yeah, Tux, he's autistic as shit. Like, by the very fucking crux of the word. But yeah, movie opens up, there's a war-torn world. Yellow Ranger and Red Ranger are fucking, you know, on the ground. They've been, you know, beaten battle or whatever. Yellow Ranger changes back. She dies. Red Ranger changes back. It's this fucking blue man, and he dies. Here's the kicker. The guy in the Red Ranger suit? It's fucking Zordon, boys! Zordon is a full-fledged fucking Power Ranger. How the fuck he became a Power Ranger is beyond me. Hold on. That's why I wanted to play like a relaxing game. I gotta play. Zordon is a full-fledged fucking Power Ranger, Tux. That man is a Red Ranger. He is an alien from space, and he is the Red Ranger. So, he dies. He buries the power coins. Fuck how? So he dies, or quote-unquote dies. Buries the power coins, and Rita's like, haha, you know, I win. XD. And then he's like, no, you don't. Then he blows himself and her up. But he survives, because, you know, it's fucking Zordon, apparently. So, movie opens with Jason, quote-unquote, leading in a fucking bull into the locker room for some kind of prank. I don't fucking know. You know, it's high school kids, right? You know, that's the shit they do. They bring bulls in the locker room for pranks. Fuck no, I'm not. So, Jason, you know, the cops pull up. Jason's like, oh shit, I need to get the fuck out of here. He gets into an accident and, you know, now he's put under house arrest. It's a fucking bull. Oh yeah, with the bull, you know, he's with the school bully. Don't know why the fuck they're hanging out or whatever the fuck they're doing. They have this scene where the school bully talks about him literally jerking off the bull. He beat off the bull. Yes, it happened. I can't make this shit up. Yeah. I'm not lying to you. I sat there and watched this. I cannot lie to your face. Rita was done okay. The way they what's it called? I can't fucking play this game right now. I gotta sit here and play a game where I can fucking talk. Hold on. Cause I'm gonna start fucking up and I'm gonna get mad. So I need something else to sit here and just fucking. I'll play Digimon. Let me save. Yeah, so your first instance of comedy is fucking the school bully jacking off a fucking bull. So Jason runs off, you know, the cops are chasing him. It's a fucking cop chase scene at the beginning of the movie. Like, Jason is literally driving full force away from the cops. Then, you know, he has to swerve. Car, you know, he fucking wrecks his car. Like, his car is shot now. And enter movie. You know, let me change my game to, yeah. So, Jason gets released from jail. He's under house arrest now. Our Red Ranger, our fucking, you know, our golden boy, our fucking goody two-shoes is now under house arrest. So he walks in, he stops, you know, it's pretty much just a montage. He's a star football player, by the way, not Mr. Karate Man. He just fucking, he's a football player, because I guess that's more relatable to Americans than, hold on, I need to turn the, I'm going to turn, music on and just kick back. Give me a second. Cause I don't, this is lagging and I wanna just kick back and turn my mind off. Give me a second. That's not even the kicker, by the way. There's a whole bunch of shit that I just dislike and it's just, it gets ugly. Like, my mom liked it and I'm glad that she liked it, cause, you know, I wanted to go originally and then she said she wanted to go, so I waited for her and then we went. But there's a lot of shit that I just didn't fucking, oh my, I just don't. Remember, guys, we have 6 of these motherfuckers now. 6 of these motherfuckers to go on. Is it playing? Yeah. Okay, this is way too slow. Hold on. I don't know what the fucking, I'm not... I mean, yeah, my franchise did just fucking explode, but I'm not sad or anything. I'm fucking upset, so. Whatever, I'll deal with that. Oh my, okay, so where was I? Oh, Jason, yeah, he's reliving his, remembering his fucking football shit. Because, you know, that's fucking... Yeah. So there's that. Then there's fucking, enter Kimberly. She walks right past Jason. They don't know each other. Because none of them are friends yet. Which is okay. You know, I get it. They're building up to something. So, Jason walks in the classroom. Enter Billy. Billy is fucking doing the most autistic thing to show you that he's autistic. He has his fucking pencils. They're all different colors. And he's organizing them and fucking all this other shit. So, Bully pulls up to him. And then he takes his pencil. He's like, what are you doing? Snaps his pencils in half. Starts snapping them one by one. Jason pulls up. And he's like, oh, you know, stop bullying this nigga. And instead of, like, doing something cool, he just fucking slaps him. He slaps him. Like, I can't remember the slap, by the way, because that'll be crucial. So, he slaps him. And then it's just like, oh, did you just slap me? Yeah, I slapped you. And it's just like, oh. It's fucking severe, bro. It's bad. So, Kimberly gets a text, she goes to the bathroom, and, you know, some fucking, some teenage girls pop out the fucking stall, and they tell her they're done with her. They cut up a picture of them together, and then they walk out. That gets explained why later. So, fuck, what the hell happens next? I think if they just leave, or whatever? Oh, no, yeah, Billy thanks Jason for fucking, you know, helping him against a bully or whatever, and he says, oh, I can help you, you know, get over your fucking... It wasn't, you know, cheesy or fun at all. It was just, you know, it was a teenage movie. That's what it was. Like, let me put it this way. People said it reminded them of The Breakfast Club. Only because they were in detention on a fucking, like, Saturday, or... Actually, no, they were just in detention at all times. That's what it was. Yeah, no, because I want to just sit here and talk, and I don't want to, like, get upset. Because I'm not doing well. Because I'm not paying attention. So Billy's like, you know, I'm smart. I can trick what the fuck is the thing called? The house arrest beacon or whatever? Or the anklet? So that he pulls up to his house, and then he takes him out to the middle of a fucking, like, quarry or some shit, and Billy's plan is to just start blowing shit up. Like, he literally has fucking dynamite, and he's blowing shit up. Enter Zach and Trini. Zach is just fucking sitting on top of a building, watching Trini, in the same quarry, by the way. This is all happening in this quarry. Jason wanders off, and Kim is fucking swimming. She's like, no bathing suit, like bra and panties, just swimming. And it's just like, oh shit. She dove in, and she's not fucking coming out. And then, you know, he calls for her, he's getting ready to jump in the water. She comes up the cut, and she's like, oh, I've never heard you say my name before, oh, blah, 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 all that other shit. And they're walking, and talking about, oh, you know, I wish I could just run away from the city, all this other fucking teenage bullshit. And then there's an explosion. Like I said, this nigga fucking Billy is, his autistic ass is blowing shit up. Just blowing shit up. By the very sense of blowing shit up. So he finds, like, you know, a fossilized wall. And in them is, you know, the power coins. The power coins are there. And Zach takes a pick. Like, you know, an ice pick or whatever. And he starts fucking, you know, chopping the shit out the wall. And they're like, what the fuck are you doing? And, oh, look, there's five power coin or coin things here. And there's five of us. Oh, and they happen to take all their respective colors. No, he doesn't have dynamite. Like, his dad, him and his dad used to go up and blow shit up. And he still does it from time to time. So, that's why he has dynamite or whatever. So yeah, note, Jason is on house arrest. He's supposed to be at home, but since Billy tricked his fucking house arrest monitor, he's able to just walk free for the rest of the movie and nobody bats an eyelash. Nobody even thinks to check this nigga's room or anything, or how did they know? It just so happened that they picked up their respective colors, quote unquote. Jason's dad is there. He's like talking shit. And they just happened to pick. Billy is smart as shit, but he's autistic as fuck in the same stroke. Like, it's crazy. Oh, that's a healer. Oops. Oh, yeah. Oh, Billy's dad is dead, by the way. His dad is dead. His dad is not, like, you know, generic black man. No, his dad is fucking dead. So, yeah. They pick up their respective power coins, and oh, look! Law enforcement pulls up again. Another car chase scene, boys! So fucking Jason and Billy run to the fucking, you know, Billy's mom's van or whatever. They're driving through the quarry, and they're like, oh, wait, we need to pick up the others. Don't know why we need to pick them up. They're fine on their own, but we need to pick them up. We have no emotional attachment to them yet. There is zero emotional attachment. By the way. We need to go pick them up. Okay. So they pick them up one by one by one. Where's Zach? And then they decide to keep, you know, fucking driving. They don't care, because Zach is kind of like, he's out there. He's just gone or whatever. This motherfucker, Zach, decided to do his best, not Liu Kang, what is it? Fucking, his best Bruce Lee fucking Jet Li shit, and jump from, like, the highest cliff onto the car, denting the roof of the car. They're like, what the fuck? They pull him into the car, and then they're driving. They're still being chased by law enforcement. It's not cops or anything yet, but it's like security for the quarry site. So, they're driving, they're going fast, things are going great. There's a train. Oh, you can beat the train. You know what that means. They're gonna get fucking hit by this train. So, Billy guns it. They cut over the fucking, like, the crossing signs or whatever. They cut over it just to get hit by the fucking train in the same second. The car is fucking totaled. And guess what? They wake up in their beds and nothing is wrong with them. Their clothes are ruined, but nothing is wrong with them. Why is the autistic kid driving? Because they swapped seats. Jason went to go pull everybody into the car. So they wake up, and this is where the fucking Spider-Man rip-off shit comes into... It's not explained how they get home. They just wake up at home perfectly fine. Jason had a knee brace at the beginning of the movie. His knee brace is off. His knee is fine. He's healed completely. So, they wake up. And they start to do their best Spider-Man impression. They each wake up at home, you know, okay. And it starts this way. Billy goes to open up his fucking, like, it's like a shed. It's not really a shed. It's like a little wardrobe closet type thing. He opens it up just to rip the fucking door off. And he's just like, oh, well, shit, this is ridiculous. He rips it off and, you know, he just starts flailing around and knocking shit off of his desk. And he's like, what the fuck is wrong with... Yelling from the top of the stairs, what the fuck is wrong with him. Next goes to Jason. Jason is he looks in the mirror in the bathroom. He's got a six-pack. He's like, oh, well, shit. He's got like a fucking eight-pack or whatever. He's like, oh, well, fuck. So, he feels like he's got to throw up. I guess he throws up in the toilet or whatever. And then, he tries to grip the sink, smashes the sink. Spider-Man, like a motherfucker. What the fuck happened? Oh, we go to Kim, and Kim fucking... I don't remember if they showed Trini or Zach at this point, but... Kim reads a text on her phone, and it's saying some off-the-wall shit or something she didn't like, and... She, you know that when you get mad, you just grip something? She smashes her fucking phone. And she's like, oh, well, what the fuck? So when they get to school, you know, they do the whole, hey, something happened, we're fine, and we've got superpowers. So they put their power coins on, you know how, like, the, in school there's a lunch line, and you know, you have, there's like a thing where you can slide your trays or whatever. So they put all three of their power coins, I skipped the part, by the way. They did the actual Spider-Man, where the bully walks up to Billy, tries to fight him, he headbutts him, hurts himself, knocks himself out, and everybody's like, holy shit, Billy's the man. Back to the lunchroom. Put the power coins on the lunch tray slider thing. It burns the shit out of the tray and heats up everything on the tray. They take it off, they run off, and then they go back to the scene of, you know, where they got their power coins. And Zach is digging at the wall again, trying to find something else to give him superpowers. He is hacking at this, because, you know, in the rush, Billy left all his shit at the site. And I guess no adult tried to check what the fuck they were doing over there. I don't know. It's really convenient that all his shit was there and Zach is just digging on the wall. Don't ask me. But yeah. So they see Trini. She's, you know, on top of the same hill that Zach is digging for some odd fucking reason. I don't know. Billy didn't beat him up. The bully beat himself up. The bully headbutted Billy and knocked himself out. That's how that should happen. Anyway, back to the fucking quarry. Trini decides she's going to start Spider-Maning, well, not Spider-Man, more like Wolverining or, you know, like, climbing really fast up this mountain. And Kim's first thought is to, like, jump as far as she can, and they can, like, super jump, by the way. They can do the original Superman where they can jump really fucking far. It's to, you know, explain how they can do all these feats of acrobatics and all this other shit. Anyway. Chase her up the hill. They do the part, if you've seen the trailer, this is the part where they're jumping over the fucking gap or whatever. Billy makes the jump after, you know, doing the most dumbass shit ever. And then he falls backwards into the crevice below, and they're just like, oh shit, he's dead. And then they hear him call from the bottom, I'm fine, they all jump down. And then in comes the power chamber. Now, they get to at the bottom of this, like, you know, river, like, ravine type thing is, you know, obviously land that you can walk on. So you cross through the water threshold, and then there's land. Oh, fuck, I'm gonna need water for this shit. So, they get to the power... This is the power chamber now. You know, it's a spaceship underground because Zordon is an alien instead of a wizard, but don't ask questions. Anyway. So, they get in the power chamber, you know, they're checking it out, it's this fucking, if you've seen Alien vs. Predator, it's that fucking ship where everything's all clicky and windy and it just looks like, you know, an alien ship, it's the most American alien ship. Like, it's the most alien ship I've ever seen in American movies. So, they hear something, and the ship is moving around. They decide to try and hide from this thing. Zach gets snatched up and pulled by a robotic mechanical arm. Who else in this series is a robot, but he's not supposed to have fucking robotic stretchy arms or whatever? Anyway, he yanks him, he pulls him, and he's like, oh, well, I've been waiting for you guys for... He does some fucking math equations. It's Alpha, by the way. He does some math equations, like, oh, well, I've been waiting for 645 years or some shit like that. 645,000 years or whatever. So, Alpha tells him to stand on these panels. It's Alpha, but yeah. He tells him to stand on the panels to start the ship up. Alpha's probably the best character in the fucking movie, because his banter just works well, even though there's no banter between anybody. At all, ever. Like, there's no good banter. Hold on, I need to take it. So, they all stand on the panels because why the fuck not, you know. They start the ship up, and out comes Zordon. Zordon is like, what the fuck is that shit? You know how there's a visual... if you haven't seen the trailer, I'm gonna explain this for you, by the way. So you know when you're looking at your media player, or like your music player on your computer, and there's the visualizer part, and it's like this really cool like up and down measuring thing? That's pretty much what Zordon is in the wall. It's not a head in a tube. No, he's this fucking spectrum shit in the wall. So he explains that. Actually, first of all, he comes out the cut talking in this fucking made-up alien language that shouldn't fucking exist. Anyway, they do that. Alpha can speak this language too, I guess, because he's, you know, sentient robot from Eltar or whatever. Yeah, he's this fucking, what the fuck? He's this visualizer thing coming out of the wall, by the way. He's a giant head that's visualized in this wall, and it's moving, and it can move all across the fucking wall and all this other extra shit. So, fuck, what the fuck? I just saw this movie, and I can't even fucking remember shit. So he's just like, you know, he downloads the English language from the ship's computer. It's a ship, by the way. It's not like even a command center. It's a legit ship now. And then he starts talking to them. He's like, wow, they're so, quote-unquote, small. You know, they're fucking kids as opposed to 8-foot aliens, apparently. Because Zordon's like an 8-foot alien before he dies, by the way. Yeah. So he starts talking shit. And then he tells them, you know, instead of giving them morphers or anything, apparently these suits are linked to, like, emotion. Or some shit. Yeah, he spends the whole movie talking shit. This is the most un-Zordon-like Zordon in the history of ever. This Zordon does not think they can do shit all. He has no faith in them. At one point, he even tells them to fucking just leave. And I'm gonna skip ahead here, by the way. Zordon wants them to unlock the morphing grid to get their suits so that he can come back to fucking life. Yeah, so, by the way, I don't know if you could tell. The morphing grid is bringing people back to life, apparently. Apparently, if you open the morphing grid, you can bring one person back. Keep in mind, you can bring one person back. So, I just skipped ahead, by the way. That's a lot later for that Zordon thing happens. Because it's quite important as to, you know, when it happens. So, they decide to leave. Or no, he tells them they're going to be Power Rangers or whatever. They decide to just leave. And they're like, oh, you know, come back at this time and we'll figure this out. So they all come back. And this is where it starts. Zordon's like, okay, try and morph. By the way, there are no morphers. You just do the thing, apparently. It just happens. So they try it. There's a big scene and nothing happens. And he's just like, shit. You guys really are fucking useless. So in starts the training montage. They literally start training against these, like, it's like in, Zordon says, take them to the pit. So the pit is literally the place that you fall into before you enter the command center. Alpha takes them out there, and they start fighting these fucking, you remember in Dragon Ball? Where Popo just drops them into, like, this dream sequence type thing. It's something like that, but it's not a dream sequence. Alpha pulls up these fucking, like, monsters or whatever, and And Zack pulls up thinking it's a hologram like a video game, and he gets washed by this fucking... He gets absolutely washed by this fucking, putty clone thing. Like, it's just fucking ridiculous. So there's the training montage, they're trying back and forth to fucking... You know, Alpha said they had 11 days before Rita pulled up, you know, or before she was back at full power to start her plan. So the days are passing, the Rangers are kinda getting close to each other, and all this other shit. I think it's day 9 or whatever, where it's like, you know, you guys are making no progress. Zordon's fed up. Zordon wants them to make fucking progress, because he wants to get his goddamn body back so he can kill Rita. Oh, yes, kill, by the way! Yeah, killing is the theme of the movie, by the way. There's a lot of this fucking kill being thrown around here. Yeah. So, what happens is, to give them quote-unquote motivation so that they can, you know, like, emotionally unlock their suits, Alpha shows them the Zords. And they're like, okay, well, you know, that's cool. They all walk away except for Zack. And guess what Zack does? Zack takes his respective Zord, you know, the black one, he takes it for a joyride. Now, this is where you find out that the Mastodon isn't a Mastodon. It's a fucking beetle! Yeah, I said it. It's not a goddamn fucking elephant anymore. It's a beetle. It's a goddamn beetle. It has 6 legs! What mastodon do you know has 6 legs? Oh, and when you see Jason's T-Rex, it has no arms. It has fucking M16s as arms. Bro, they went all out to make this not Power Rangers. Like, I can't even tell you how just, like, when I saw the actual Zords, I was just so disgusted. Like, I wasn't even mad. I was in shock at first when I saw that this thing had 6 fucking legs, and I was just like, wait, what is that? That's not an elephant. Yeah, the Triceratops has 6 too, I think. Yeah, these things are running around with 6 fucking legs. A saber-toothed tiger looks more like a fucking, like, bear. I don't want to say bear. Bear is not nice. Looks more like a fucking, I don't know, a jackal or some shit than a saber-toothed tiger. Yeah, no, it definitely looks more like a big-ass fucking jackal than anything. And, you know, the only fine one really is the bird, because it's a bird. How can you fuck up a bird, you know? I was in shock. I was like, I was like, as the movie went on, I could feel my body getting hotter, not because it was hot in the theater, but because I was just so upset. Like, towards the end of the movie, I was legit hottish. I had to take my jacket off. That's how hot I was. Like, I can't believe how fucking just... Holy shit! So, Billy makes the joke, you know, the fucking, are we more like Iron Man or Spider-Man, because, you know, we're superheroes, blah, blah, blah. That happens the first time they go on the ship or whatever, before the training montage and whatnot. Oh, they also mention the Zeo Crystal, by the way. Like, the Zeo Crystal, in the actual Power Rangers, like lore or whatever, it's not mentioned until midway through season 2/season 3. Like, it's the whole plot point for season 3. The Zeo Crystal is in play in the first movie. It's buried somewhere on Earth, and it's what's powering the Earth, according to Zordon. How the fuck the Zeo Crystal powers the Earth is beyond me. I don't fucking know. I don't... It's a goddamn mystery. Oh, by the way, there's a lot of, you know, product placement for Krispy Kreme. I don't know why. Kimberly and Trini are in a Krispy Kreme during the training montage. Yes, the Zeo Crystal is a source of power of each planet. Yes. How do you power a planet? Fuck if I know. So, Zack is learning from Alpha, you know, all about the Zeo Crystal. And he is writing everything down, and he, you know, pinpoints the location on Earth of where it could be. And guess where it is, boys? It's under the fucking Krispy Kreme! The place where the Zeo Crystal is? Under the fucking Krispy Kreme! Yep. He tracks it there. You know, things are still going terrible, and then Zordon tells him to just go home. You know, you guys are fucking useless. Jason walks back, and that's when he hears Zordon's plan to fucking, you know, bring himself back and lead the team himself, because he's had enough of this shit. Yeah. Goon, I'll get to that shit later. Don't worry, I'll get to that. But that shit is just... Wow. Wow, my fucking brain is... Bro, I was heated, like, halfway through this whole movie. Because there's no action. Like, the training montage is the closest thing you get to action before the end of the movie. Literally, in between. It's just this fucking teenage drama bullshit that no one asked for. Like, they leave after Zordon tells them to fuck off, and they camp out outside of where, you know, on the mountain or whatever. And they're, you know, going to get rid of them, or not rid of themselves, wow. They get used to each other. Trini tells everybody she's gay. She doesn't really tell them that she's gay, but she hints at being gay. Everybody's talking about their problems, except for Kimberly. Kimberly decides to be, you know, the fucking special snowflake. Nah, I'm not telling you guys. Not now. So they try again. Nothing happens. And they all go home again. Now, Trini's sleeping. Fucking something starts dripping on her. And Rita pulls up. Now, wait. I forgot a very important aspect of the story that they never reference ever. Ever! Well, they reference it, you know, when she's on screen, but ever! Jason is- Oh, fuck! That's how fucking- Yes! Jason is still on house arrest! He's never been home, and nobody knows he's missing! Like, holy shit, he's still on house arrest, and nobody knows. Like, nobody has realized that this nigga has never been home. I don't know where his mom is, but his dad is, like, never home. Probably Fallen Knight. Like... Oh my god. Rita is a ranger. They say at the beginning when Zordon's going through his whole spiel of how they're Power Rangers and all this other shit, Rita is an ex-ranger, and guess what motherfucking color she is? Don't worry, I'll wait. She is motherfucking green, boys! Like, I just can't. My mind is full. Like, she has her staff or whatever, and she puts the green power coin in her staff. And that's what power is, her shit. Like, that shit is just... My mind is full of fuck when I saw that shit. So anyway, back to the important part of the story. Trini's sleeping in her room, something's dripping on her, she's like, what the fuck? She looks up, it's Rita! How did Rita find her? Fuck if I know! She has never seen these motherfuckers before, but she knows she's a Power Ranger. And she knows what color she is! She knows exactly what color she is! And she even knows that Zack knows... Or not Zack, that Billy knows where the Zeo Crystal is. How the fuck does she know? It's beyond me! So, she tells Trini to meet her at the shipyard or whatever. Yeah, she read it on Twitter. Jesus fucking Christ. Yeah. Anyway, fucking, Trini calls the Rangers together, because, you know, at this point, they all have each other's numbers and all that shit. They stage an emergency meeting. They still can't morph, by the way. This is the fucking, what's it called? This is starting to build up. This is starting to build up to the end of the movie. Like we are... Literally, there's a quarter left of the movie, and they still cannot morph. So, they fucking, they all go they go to the shipyard or whatever, and they pick up the shittiest things, like, they pick up a pipe, a chain, and some other fucking fodder weapons. Or whatever, and they try to go at Rita. Obviously, she shits on all of them, ties them up and ties them to the fucking boat. And then she's asking them, oh, you know, I could kill you all. Where the fuck is the Zeo Crystal? I don't know. One of you knows, and she gets to the black nigga. Ha! I know you know where it is. How the fuck she knows is fucking beyond me. Like, I'm just so upset. I can't even... I just don't... I don't care. Anyway, she gets her information... He tells her it's at the fucking Krispy Kreme, and she drops him in the fucking water. Anyway. Yeah, because they're at a shipyard or whatever. Rita's been sitting at this fucking shipyard, and it's just... My mind is blown right the fuck now. Like, I just don't... I wish I was taking notes during the fucking movie. Like, that's just... Yeah, and just like a fucking... Yeah, she drops him into the fucking ocean, tied up and chained up, so he drowns. This nigga dies, bro! No, this nigga Billy drowns, bro. Like straight up drowns, dead. So they carry him Jesus Christ style to the power chamber. Remember what I said earlier? They carry him to the power chamber, Jason's like, you know, do something, and he's like, I can't, you know? I can't do anything. So they're all feeling sad and shit. You know, it's all this sad shit. And because of their emotions, the morphing grid opens up. Oh, it's time for Zordon to bring himself back. So Zordon, you know, pulls himself into the morphing grid. And everything goes, you know, everything gets dark. They're like, what the fuck happened? Zordon comes back. Oh, what the fuck, Zordon? What happened? Oh, it didn't work? Oh, there can only be one. So on some Highlander shit. At the second he says that, Billy starts coughing up water. He's alive! Oh, shit, boys! He's back from the dead! And now they morph. They stand on the fucking platform. They all stand in their places. And they morph into, you know, fucking Power Rangers. Yeah, Zordon finally comes around and he's just like, you guys are my Rangers, I respect you niggas, you know, blah, 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 all that other shit. So, at the same time... So, at the same time, Rita is walking around the quarry site, and this is where she decides to build Goldar. Why? Because she knows where the power chamber is by some act of fucking God. By some act of God, she knows where the power chamber is. How the fuck does she know where it is? She's building Goldar. Oh yeah, Goldar isn't a fucking... Yeah, Wheezy. He literally treats them like shit the whole movie. And then when he realizes, you know, wow, they're really close and they could probably do it, he just fucking brings Billy back to life. He wastes the morphing. Also, the morphing grid is like this big fucking cosmic thing. I don't remember what movie it's related to. But think of like you know all the diagrams they do where it's like this really smoky color thing. Where there's planets or whatever. That's what the fucking... It kind of looks like this cosmic force type thing. Where it's just in the middle of the fucking... the ship. the morphing grid is on display. In the middle of the goddamn command chamber. But yeah, so they're morphed now. There's no morphers. I don't know why. I don't care anymore. So they go outside. They hear Rita's outside. Before they can even leave the pit, Putties dropped out. Putties are pretty much just rock men. Like they're not even like the cute little shitty monsters. They're just fucking rocks. Anyway. They drop down into the fucking quarry. Not the quarry, the ravine. They drop into the ravine. They're fighting. Up top, Rita... They're fighting their way to the top of the ravine just to see Goldar back in full force running, walking towards the city. So, it's Zord time. Cool. They suit up. The Zords are going... Oh, I forgot. Rewind a bit. When Zack takes the fucking Mastodon for a joyride, he just goes on a rampage because he obviously can't control it. But why the fuck would you be able to get in the Mastodon with the power coin when you can't even morph? Like, how does that even... I don't care. Anyway. He goes on a joyride with the fucking thing. He almost runs over a bus of nuns or some shit. Then, he crashes into the pit and almost kills everyone, and they're like, what the fuck? This is all before they morph and all that other shit. Zack and Jason start fist fighting, like legit fist fighting. Billy stops them, and then he morphs for about a couple of seconds. They couldn't morph because they weren't emotionally connected to the morphing grid. It's a really dumbass reason, don't ask me why. It's to get that really feel-good ending. Yeah, and Zordon's like, oh, you guys still aren't ready, this is ridiculous. You know, he's pissed off now, because Zack took the fucking Beetle for a joyride, and Billy morphed for 3 seconds. So yeah, fast forward back to, you know, the fucking rising action or whatever. Now we're in the Zords. They're running towards the city. They remind you, everything in this fucking movie, every Zord has a gun mounted on it. Why? Because America. Everything has a gun on it. The pterodactyl's fucking beak, a gun. It's a rail gun. The tusks of the Mastodon, a fucking machine gun. Triceratops machine gun, saber-toothed tiger fucking back lasers, or fucking, you know, all that other shit. Everything is lined with fucking guns. And guess what happens next? They're going into the city. You can see people running, you know, through the city. They're shooting at the putties on the ground where the people were not even 10 seconds ago. They are shooting into civilian lines. They are doing the most reckless, like, there's a scene where Kim is flying above, and she shoots into the street where Rita was, where there's people running across the fucking street. Like, this is not an abandoned city. They are shooting into the fucking street. Now, midway through this is another feel-good moment, by the way. Jason's dad is trying to contact him. He's driving through the city. When he's on the phone, he says he's on the corner of Mariner Bay and some other fucking, Mariner Bay and some other street. I can't actually remember which one. Now, this is good because Mariner Bay was the city that Power Rangers Lightspeed Rescue took place in. That's pretty cool. That's the only part that I like, by the way. It shows that they're not complete idiots. Now, Jason's dad gets knocked over by Goldar. Like, his car gets flipped over. Now, that's three. Count them, three. Three times that a car has been fucking flipped and slash blown up. Beginning of the movie, Jason wrecks his car. Midway through the movie, Billy wrecks his mom's fucking van. Jason's dad's truck gets fucking wrecked. That's three car crashes in the same way. They all end up upside down. It's wonderful. Now, Jason sees his dad, and it's just like, oh, he needs to go help him. And his dad's afraid of him because, you know, their suits look like fucking putties for some odd reason. Where are the parents? Oh, Trini's parents are like, you know, freaks. They're like born-again Christians that treat her, like, really weird. Like, it's not abuse. Like, they wanna, you know, like, you know, be in her life, but they're really controlling and weird. So she's going through her rebellious phase. So, Jason gets out to help his dad and all this other shit. And then, you know... Yeah, Tuck, she's the gay one. That's why it's really fucking... His dad's afraid of him. To get his dad out of the car, he calls him by government name. So Jason has broken the rule of the fuck... One of the three rules. One of the three rules that he was given. He just broke the shit. Because his dad knows now. His dad obviously didn't say anything about it, but he knows. He knows he's a fucking Red Ranger now. You were given three rules. And he broke it. So now we're back to fighting or whatever. Oh, I skipped ahead, by the way. That happens a bit later, but yeah. They're fighting Goldar in the Zords yet. And they're not doing anything. You know, it sucks. They can't fucking beat Goldar with their shitty little fucking... So you're wondering where the Megazord is, right? Here's the fucking kicker. Goldar digs up the fucking Zeo Crystal, and guess what you see in this little pit thing? In the pit, you see the morphing grid, like, CGI thing, but it's green. I don't know why, I guess for life? Green represents life or whatever? So, the Zeo Crystal is surrounded by this morphing grid green shit. And the Rangers are getting pushed back into the fucking, into the pit. Yeah, the Krispy Kreme got blown up and they're fucking... Oh yeah, and Goon said it earlier. Before Goldar digs up the Krispy Kreme, you enjoy a scene of Rita, eating a donut. Oh yeah, and before that, when he tells her it's in a Krispy Kreme, she assumes Krispy Kreme is this fucking, you know... like, government facility where the Zeo Crystal is being held. No, it's a fucking convenience store. Or not even a convenience store, it's just a, like a... I can't call it a restaurant, but... But yeah, so they all get... They're all huddled together. Like, you know, they're all close together being pushed into the pit. They get pushed into the pit. And... By some act of God, they just happen to make the Megazord. Zordon didn't call them and tell them, hey, you need to bring your shit together. No, Zordon is completely fucking absent for the rest of the movie from here on. Even though we're in the last, like, 30 minutes, or not even 30. The last, like, yeah, no, I'd say 30. The last 30 minutes of the movie, Zordon and Alpha are nowhere to be seen. Like, as soon as they morph and turn into Power Rangers, you never hear from Zordon or Alpha ever again. So, yeah. So, now they make this fucking bastard Daijujin, where it's fucking just black and ugly, and, oh, here's the fucking kicker. They're connected to these fucking Zords. And, but, like, Eva Matrix style. Like, there's a fucking, like, cord or whatever that shoots into their back and pulls them into place. Like, that shit was just... Oh my god! Like, this is the most Eva-style fucking Megazord I've ever seen. This thing is just black and ugly and... Oh, they fucking trip, by the way, like... While they're walking forward, they trip because, haha, everybody has to control a different part. Like, there are orbs on the Megazord's body that, you know, signify which ranger is controlling what. And then they forget that they have to control, you know, the limbs of the fucking thing. Like, Jesus. Like, have you ever seen The Matrix? You know how you enter the Matrix and it shoots into your fucking, like, retinal system or whatever? Or not retinal, the fucking spinal system? It's like that, but it shoots directly into their back and yanks them into place. Like, motherfuck. This shit is bad, bro. Like, I just... Oh, damn. Wow. Yeah, I'm very red and hot right now. But yeah. So the Megazord, you know, they beat Goldar, but it's not over yet. They said, "Oh, we're going to bring you in, hand over your power coin, and we'll let Zordon, you know, pass judgment on you." Rita jumps at them, and guess what Jason does? Guess what Jason has fucking Kim do? Or Trini, whichever one is controlling the fucking arm. He slaps her. And guess what Billy says? Did you just slap him? Yeah, I did. Ha ha ha. And then, you know, movie's over, pretty much. The civilians gather, and in the middle of the civilians, you can see Tommy or Jason David Frank and Kimberly, you know, Amy Jo Johnson taking pictures in the crowd, which is pretty cool. It's that shit. And then the movie's pretty much over, you know, now it's the epilogue. Jason comes back in his ranger suit, and he fucking puts his sword in some kind of compartment fucking thing, where Zordon's like, you know you need to keep that, right? Because it's not over. And then, Jason's like, I'll come back when I need it, and it's just like, what the fuck are you doing? Why? Why? Why would you leave it in the goddamn command center? Like, anyway, he walks out. They're living their lives. And all this other shit. And movie's over. Credits roll. All that other stuff. And then, you know, at the end of the pre-credits, their detention teacher is like, oh, well, we have a new student in class. Tommy Oliver. He calls for Tommy like 3 times. And all you see is an empty desk with a green sweatshirt on it. Yeah. That's it. Oh yeah, and by the way, they're panning out to the school after they do the Tommy Oliver thing, and Billy's locker blows up. They reference it earlier in the movie that he blew up his lunchbox, and that's why he was in detention. But yeah. Any cameos? Yeah, you had the original Tommy and the original Kimberly at the end of the movie. That's about it. Nobody else is in the movie. Yeah, so the next movie is Rita giving the green power coin to Tommy. Like I said, I told you guys, I plotted out their whole movie scheme. I told you exactly what they were going to do in their movies. And they did it. I can read these cocksuckers like books. Like, this shit is just crazy. The shit is actually free. That's just... Oh, man. It was a fucking trip. Like... I'm not gonna recommend this to anyone. I wouldn't recommend this movie at all. Like, I just... It's a movie. That's about it. Nah, Shadow Star, it's gonna look worse. If all the Zords looked that bad, they gave the Triceratops and the Mastodon 6 legs and all this other shit. They just, I'm upset, man. I really just don't know, man. Like, there was nothing. Would I see it again? Yeah, no, the end scene? No, Shadowstar, you can fuck up a dragon, bro. I'm gonna get the picture. I sent it to Tux. I'll get you the picture. Yeah, if you can do that, you could definitely fuck up Caesar. Easily. That's what I was watching. That's what I was looking at for about 10 minutes. Caesar is gonna look like shit. The suits are just, oh my god. Oh, wow. There's just... They did really... Oh, yeah! And I know I saw this in Pony's Discord the other... or not the other day, but earlier, like, literally right before I saw the movie. Literally, the second they get the Zords and ride out, right out of the, as soon as they get the Zords in right out of the command center, that's when the movie version of the theme plays, and it's for 8 seconds, and you never hear it again. You never hear it again. You don't hear it at the beginning, you don't hear it at any other point. You hear it at that one spot, and never again. 8 seconds. They made a whole theme for 8 seconds. Like, yeah, you can just call me an angry Toku or angry, you know, nostalgia Power Rangers fanboy or whatever. But if you're gonna call it Power Rangers and you're gonna do your own thing, like, it's just... Jesus Christ. This is bad, bro. Like, this shit is horrid. Like, you know what? I'm probably gonna have to ask people if they want to see it. Cause I need to see a general person's take on it. Like, they literally took everything and bastardized it. Like, I've never been so just shocked in my life. Oh, when I hear It's My Universe, I'm just gonna be like, okay, you wrote this shit. No, what makes me mad is you wrote... It's the same nigga that wrote the movie is the same nigga that wrote the fucking shows. Like, holy fuck, I am so mad. Oh my god. Like, when I tell you... Oh my god. It's the same... Yeah, it has to be the same people, unless I'm wrong. Hold on, let me see. Because there's no way. There's no way that they... I assume it's the same guys. Because he oversaw the project. Like, when I tell you, this is just... Like, you're the producer. I don't really know what the producer does. I assume he like, you know, is a really important person in the making of a movie. But when you read through this script, did you just like not? Did you tell them all this shit was okay? Like, well, nobody wants to see their shit fail. But it's just like, did you really like? You were okay with this happening? Like, I just don't... It blows my mind, man. Like, I just... Yeah, so... In about 2 years' time or so, when the next one comes out, I'll be there. Will I be a happy camper? No. Am I a happy camper right now? No. I'm not. Not a fiber in my being is happy right now. Did I get my money's worth? No. I paid $11 for this shit. Like, I just... Yeah, they want 5 more movies, and what are they gonna... Like, they're gonna do everything from Mighty Morphin Power Rangers over again in a movie, Sextet. But it's gonna be bad. Like, if they did this much damage in 1 2-hour movie, if they did this much damage in a fucking 2-hour movie, I don't want to see what they're gonna do over the course of 6 movies. Cause this is ridiculous. Like, that's just... It's... Honestly, I'd be fucking livid if I didn't know what I was getting into. Oh, hold on, I don't even know what quest I'm doing. Actually, I can stop playing, so I'm not explaining the movie anymore. I can go back to Mega Man. I don't want to see anything. Anything at all. I just... Oh god, I just don't know. I don't want it. I didn't think it was possible, but it's possible. Like, holy shit. By all means, if you want to go see the movie, go ahead and see the movie, but just go in there not expecting a Power Rangers movie and you'll be fine. Which Digimon did I name X? I don't remember. Hold on, I can go check for you. Give me a second. Like, that's just... Jesus Christ. That was... If you want to enjoy the movie, go in there with zero expectations and don't think of it as a Power Rangers movie. It's one of those movies. X is... What is X? Did I name... Is it in the Farm Island? Oh, X is Andromon. There you go. Yeah, I just don't know, man. Like, I didn't expect anything special. If it didn't have Power Rangers or Power Ranger in the movie, would I call it a good movie? No, it's very generic. Like, without the Power Rangers part, it's just your generic teen fucking coming-of-age film. Yeah, she said, make my monster go, and it's like, okay, yeah, ha, nice throwback. And there's that. Yeah. There was not a lot to enjoy. Like I said, the most you can enjoy... No, you never see his lunchbox blow up. Like, you can only assume that the blow up in the post-credits scene is his lunchbox, but... You never know. I'm trying to get to this thing over here. I gotta find it before I go into the Wave World, because it's just gonna bother me if I don't. I guess it's from here. Yeah, I saw we got into a bridge. I was gonna watch it before I went live, but I had, before I experienced something happy, I had to vent. I had to vent at least once. I think I'm gonna have to wave out if I can do the thing. You know, I just don't care what they do with things anymore. Like, they can just... If they want this shit so bad, they can have it. Like, just take this shit. Computer exploded? God bless, man. By the time the sixth movie is over, what year is it gonna be? If it's two for each, then it's probably 2028, yeah. It depends. Cause they have to make six now. Well, yeah, I don't know how you love the fuck out of that movie. The movie sucked. That movie blew dicks. I mean, it's not a Death Note movie. It's inspired by a Death Note. It's just using the idea of the Death Note and telling a story. Hold on, where is this thing? Like, I can have hope for things where it's, you know, spiritual successors, but... Or not even, just like, you know, something different. Where the hell? How do I get over here? How did I miss that? So here would be the... Okay. Actually, I can add another ability. I just don't know, man. I don't want my money back. You can have it. I'm not. You know what? I'm just happy that at the end of the day, I can boot up my computer and go watch some some quality Sentai that people actually cared, that, you know, people cared about and made. Just have my money. It's a fucking shit show. Anyone that sees that, anyone that says that movie is good, either doesn't know what the fuck they're talking about. they either don't know what the fuck they're talking about, or they're just not, they're blind. Like, they're legit blind. I'm watching the new Sentai. I haven't watched it yet. I like the idea of there being so many characters to work with from the start. Like, Q Ranger is actually really interesting. I like it. It's just, Yeah, no, they definitely tried to, they're trying to baby step people into the Power Rangers world. You must be joking. What was the latest Power, or the last Power Rangers season I saw? I think the most recent thing was, I saw a bit of, Dino Charge. I watched Megaforce because I wanted to see what they were going to do with, Gokaiger. Fam, go take your mom to watch that movie and then play back. Or just tell her everything I said. Like, my mom liked it. She was just like, if they actually killed Billy, I never would see the movie ever again. She was like, she wasn't gonna support their movies if Billy was actually like legit dead. Yeah, because Ninja Steel's gonna take, what's it called? Okay, so I don't got a cold body. Old binocular. Oh, yeah, they're taking a lot of, things from what's it called. My mom liked it because, you know, it's just, she can fucking recognize things, you know, like... She can easily recognize, you know, shit is supposed to be the way it was. And even she realized that it was weird that they had fucking guns, bro. What did it say? Okay, that's it. Okay. Like, when my mom, who has barely seen Power Rangers... can fucking recognize that there's not supposed to be a gun mounted on fucking everything? We have a problem, bro. Yeah, I'm currently finishing up the Ninja. And then I'm gonna go do, Juhoger. Excuse me. God bless. Oh, God. What up, nigga? Hey, you missed me going on a fucking tirade about how bad the Power Rangers movie was. Oh, you missed? You were here, alright. You probably caught a bit of it, you know what I'm saying? Old binoculars. Where is that? Hold on. Yeah, oh my God, like, but when I tell you that I was fucking heated, that by the end of the movie I was like boiling hot. Oh my God. Like, my goodness, I just... There's a box here. Oh, jeez. Yeah, I'll probably take your guys' advice and upload it to YouTube. My good note, nigga, I just watched, you know, everything I love and care for get bastardized. Like, what the fuck? Let's put it this way. If you don't actually like the series and you like guns, you'll like it. If you like teenage drama, you'll like it. If you like fucking, very generic movie humor, you'll like it. You know, it's one of those things where it wasn't made for a certain type of fans. Like, it's one of those things where if you're expecting special treatment, if you're expecting special treatment for being a fan, you're not gonna get it. You're gonna get it in very small increments. Like, you know, the Mariner Bay thing, Tommy and Kimberly being in the movie, like the original Tommy and Kimberly. Yeah, I want to watch Last Airbender if anyone's down. I'm probably going to stop in a bit and watch that shit. Yeah, no, for movies like that, you have to go in there not expecting the anime. Only expect the character names. Oh, that doesn't go too far, okay. I need something to cleanse my fucking palate after watching that travesty. The Hertz that sells cold body? And the way of the old binocular? What the fuck? Oh, I didn't get the right thing. I got the fucking, what's it called? I got the thing to get the Mega Buster. Yeah, Pony, we're watching the M. Night Shyamalan fucking, fucktacular. I guess I want to, I'm going to call it a fucktacular. Because there's nothing spectacular about it. Martha vs. Martha, man. The movie was dick, Tux. I don't have to tell you the movie was dick. What kind of shit is this? The fucking Curry Man clan are in. Shin Godzilla, that shit sounds lit. I'm down. Rather watch Dragon Ball Evolution. I'm not gonna, like, I've seen half of the movie before, and it's just like, oh god. Like, that's a movie that they genuinely didn't try on. That's for damn sure. They didn't reference SPD. It was Lightspeed Rescue. Mariner Bay is Lightspeed Rescue. Okay, I actually haven't. I've been slacking on Voltron. Is really trying to watch Dragon Ball Evolution? Like, what the fuck? How badly have I been slacking? Every time I look at Netflix, I watch a different show. That's how badly I've been slacking. I'm a big fan. I'm down to do like a whole movie marathon. Oh my god, I'm so glad that I only read Man of Steel, like I read not synopsis, but I read the plot. I'm so glad I didn't watch that movie, because if I did, I would have just, like, I would have died in my chair. Oh my god, it's... Pony, no. No, listen. It is no. Oh my god. Holy fuck. And I'm not even tired, I'm just sad. I've made like no progress in like the past 3 days. Oh, God. I just... Naruto has hope because Kishimoto is there, but at the same time, this movie had hope as well. Like, it's not like this movie didn't have hope. I lost hope when I saw the suits, but I was like, nah, this might be okay. Then I saw the Zords, and I wanted to, like, fucking jump in traffic, and I was like, you know what? I'll give him a little bit, you know what I'm saying? I'll give him a little bit of leeway. And then I saw everything else, and I was just like, wow. Just wow. Yeah, no, Japan's live actions are always on point, and then they come to America, and it sucks. Like, the Americans try and do it, and it blows cocks. Oh, God. God. I could have honestly written a better, like, script. Not a script, like, the banter is whatever. Believe it. I just can't wait, man. Yeah, I heard about the JoJo's one. I'm pretty sure those are all Japanese, though, aren't they? JoJo by America? Jesus. That's gonna be weird. See you guys in 24 months. I just have to like drop off the face of the planet. Like, I just don't. I'm just so mad. Oh my God. It feels like someone's giving me the evil eye. That's not fair, hello? Again, sucked again. Nah, Zabuza's is gonna look like every fucking zombie does. Okay, Pony, but you know they're not gonna do just the Land of Waves. They're gonna do everything leading up to the Land of Waves. They're gonna make one movie and it's gonna be like fucking shit. It's gonna fall over and just break. You can't. Nowadays, if you're gonna make a movie on a series, you can't just do one. I don't know what's wrong with people. You tell Sonya to stay back. Great. Yeah, if they end up doing part two, Sasuke's actually gonna have eyeliner. And they're gonna ruin the scene in the hospital, because Sasuke's gonna have eyeliner, like, the instant he starts resenting Naruto, he's gonna have eyeliner. Oh, they're all over the fucking place, what the hell? Like, you see what they did to Light in the fucking, in the Death Note shit? That's how Sasuke is gonna look, like, after the Land of Waterfalls. And all that other shit. Yeah, I hit Hollywood too, don't worry. I just wanna write for these fucking things, man. Like, I wanna either write for a video game or just write for a movie. Oh my god, are you fucking real? I want to write for the movies and cast them. Like, I want to be able to like, fucking just... Oh, did I just get sucked? How much does that do? What the hell is this? Oh, it's where everyone is. How do I get out of here? For the Bleach one, I mean, Bleach isn't good to begin with, so I had no hopes. So that one I'll be able to rest easy and watch. Dude, how the fuck do I get out of here? Yeah. What? Orochimaru is gonna look like every, you know, Hollywood zombie ever, too. Orochimaru and Zabuza are just gonna be zombies, that's all it is. CGI'd Kurama, yeah, I mean, it could be cool. Oh yeah, they're most definitely gonna change the hairstyles. The only ones that'll stay the same are the easy ones to like, you know, do. Like, Naruto's is pretty easy to do. So that one will stay. Lee's will stay. Sakura will stay. You know, and the only ones I get changed are really like Sasuke's and Kakashi's. maybe Asuma and Sarutobi will stay, because they did fuck, because they did fucking what's it called? They did Heihachi in the Tekken movie, and it wasn't too bad. Didn't look like Heihachi, but hey, better than nothing. Okay, Kakashi's not gonna be bald. I mean, Choji's is easy to do. You can just get one of those wigs. There are wigs for Choji that you can do very easily. Kami Kakushi device. Scrap Giba completely, Jesus. You see, Pony, they should only bring those characters, but you know they're gonna do everything. They're gonna touch on everything. Naruto, you mean my nigga, Nick? my nigga, Nathaniel? my nigga, Nathaniel was my... What the hell is that? Kenneth Howard. Nick Saul and Sonya, yeah. My nigga is, Solomon. The third Hokage, Solomon. Michael Namikaze. That shit is... Oh my god. Oh yeah, it's not Gar, it's Gavin. This is like early on in the game. Tamara. Tsunade, you mean Sarah? Conqueror of Kenny. My nigga Ned. Jiraiya, aka Jonathan. Oh my god, fucking Oscar. Oscar Uchiha, holy shit. That's lit. Nah, Madara would be fucking Marcus Uchiha. He's Chris now, yeah. Stuart, okay. That's enough. Darius? Holy shit. Yeah, Darius is definitely Darius. Billy Uzumaki. Kushina would just be Karen. And Catherine or some shit like that. It's time to power up. Okay, they're not gonna change Pain's name. Pain is already a good English name. Oh, fuck. Sons of the Daniel Fuck you mean? I wish my game wouldn't lag, dude. Holy shit! Oh, Boro! I don't know why that shit was lagging so hard when I tried to fight this guy. That's so drastic. Obito to Larry? Alright, I'm gonna get out of here. Because it's late. And I don't want to stream too much longer. So I'm probably gonna do a rabbit. I'm probably gonna go get something to eat first. So yeah, thanks for watching. And I'm probably gonna upload this. That little review rant thing to YouTube. So yeah, there's that. I'm out of here.